biggest requirement of a jiva is Ishwar only. The Lord, because I have said many times, as long as the microcosm is not associated with the macrocosm, microcosm will feel powerless. As long as this finger or this hand is not associated with the whole body, this hand will become weak. The nourishment of the microcosm is through the macrocosm. And that nourishment is possible only when the microcosm is working for the macrocosm. So macrocosm nourishes the microcosm and gives its power, and microcosm gives its seva to the macrocosm. So therefore, it is not wise living where I know I am powerless on certain issues and I am not going to the one who is all-powerful. When something is all-powerful, it is always wiser to approach that powerful and get connected to that infinite source of power, so that I don't feel alone, I don't feel lonely, I don't feel lost in this quagmire of samsara. Before again I touch this rudram, one or two points I'll repeat it. Remember I said yesterday, there are hundreds of powers in this world. Like your body has power, lot of power, power of lifting, power of walking, power of talking, power of thinking, power of moving. So there are hundreds of millions of powers are there in this world. Power of sun, power of moon, power of earth, power of giving many fruits, power of so many knowledges are there. So I was in Goa, one girl came and she said, "Bole Swamiji, I don't believe in God, I believe in some big power." I was leaving for airport, otherwise I would have explained more. But one thing is there, that any power cannot exist without powerful. My power of speech is dependent on me. Power by itself cannot do unless there is a wielder of the power. And the wielder of the power is not inert entity. Power cannot be held by the power. There is a rule. If power is there, there has to be the powerful also. When you say that this world has lot of powers, then you have to say that there is one powerful also who is the holder of all power. You cannot say that I believe in power but I don't believe in powerful. It is only showing that I have not thought sufficiently. When a person is dead, because there is no wielder of power, therefore all powers also have gone from the person. Similarly, if there is a big power, which you will believe that there are millions of powers, then you have to also believe that there is a equally bigger powerful. Okay. Why I am reiterating, so that we get more established in prayers. And one who has power, therefore he is called omnipotent. One who is all powerful is called omnipotent. His power is there. Now they classify power into five. So power of creation, power of sustenance, power of dissolution, power of gracing, and power of punishing. In this world, everything has all five powers. Not only God, we also have. We also have. Yes. Ant also have. Ant also has. Yes. Really, yes. Because ant also can produce some ant from itself. So it has power of creativity. Everything we can create. We can create child. We can something we can create. Therefore, we also are mini Ishwar. Mini Ishwar. Micro Ishwar. So we also have power. At least we can create confusion if nothing is. So first is, so we can create something. Mother can create a child. She has a power to create a child. Father has a power to create a child. And she sustains the child also by taking care. But she is not destroying the child. But we can destroy something. I can tear this paper. I can destroy something. Destruction in Panini Vyakrana is a typical word. You know what is the meaning of destruction? Panini says, Adarshane Naam Nasha. So what is Nash? Adarshane. Not seeing it. Taking away the form itself is called Nash. Matter is not destroyed, that form is no more now. The five elements of the body are not destroyed. Only form goes away. That same five element, supposing it is buried, from there pumpkin can come out. So this body is future pumpkin. So that is not destroyed. So there is a power of creativity, there is a power of sustenance, and there is a power of destruction also. The cow also can create one calf. It can sustain by giving its milk. It can destroy something. When it eats grasses, it destroys the grass. Power of blessing, it can bless by giving milk also. And by using the horn, it can punish also. Everything, even ant is there. Ant can create an ant, it can create an ant hill, it can sustain, it can jump in the water and milk and destroy the milk. It can bite, it can punish you also. And it can it can give some blessings all in the form that it can protect from some other insects. Water also. Water can create, it can create electricity, so many things. Water sustains life. And water can wet everything, only water has destroyed the whole thing. Water can bless a person also when he requires, and water can create a deluge like in Bombay and this Maharashtra. And therefore water can nigraha also. So everything has five powers. Srishti Shakti, Sthiti Shakti, Lay Shakti, Anugrah Shakti, Nigrah Shakti. We also can do something. We also can create, maintain. Well, I have created one house, at least we created. Then I can destroy something. Then I can punish somebody. And I can love somebody. One person who really loves you, he can do a lot for you, even if he's a servant also. One servant also can do a lot for you. And one person who doesn't like you, he can create sufficient problem in your life. Only he has a nuisance value. One speck is there. When it goes in the eyes, it can create sufficient problem. One stone appears nothing, but supposing it goes in the kidney, small speck. I had a stone, therefore I'm telling. So doctor said, okay, I'm showing this. This biggest stone, hardly Nothing is there. But moment it goes in the kidney and it goes through the particular veins, it can create terrible pain. This is terrible nigra shakti, everything is here. And anugra shakti is also there. The power of blessings also is there. Everything in this world is with these five powers. You agree? I hope so. Everything is. Yes. One person, you know, I am single, what can I do for you? You can do a lot. If one person is conducive to you, he can really help you in many ways. If these five shaktis are there, same five shakti, it is in Ishwar also. The same Ishwar has created the world, sustains the world, destroys the world. He wants to bless, then he can bless somebody. That is his option. It is up to you whether you want to love somebody or not love somebody. And if he wants, he can punish also terribly. The one who has these five shakti is called Rudram. And because he is the maker of the whole world and he has all power in his hand, we have little power. Our power is very less. Small powers we have. And that too for a short time. And that too goes away. It is on lease. It will go away. Our power of talking goes away, walking goes away. But his power doesn't go away. He is Nitya Shaktishali. We are Alpa Nitya Shaktishali. We have little power, that too for some time. That power goes away. The art of getting that infinite power and making enriched with our power, that art, that technique is called prayer, and that technique is called upasana. Upasana and aradhana is catching that infinite power for my own self so that his anugraha shakti should be for me and his nigraha shakti should not come to me. Although I am worth punishing on certain issues, only you know your mistakes very well. All your mistakes nobody knows in this world. Rather, your mind does, nobody knows your mind totally. Husband doesn't know wife's mind totally. Wife doesn't know husband's mind. And if they know it, they will leave each other, as far as I think. So, God has put one nice, you know, body so that your mind cannot be seen. Because if you see each other's mind, you will never be able to live with that person. So the terrible minds are there. Only is thinking like this. We are not livable after that. But imagine the God who knows not only my mind but all the powers also, still he blesses. And therefore I says, don't put your nigra upon me. So repeatedly in Rudram it will be said, please take away your arrow, please take away your bows. Because he is seeing many of my actions which were wrong. Many times I got angry unnecessarily. Many times I hurt somebody. Many times I walked and I trampled many insects also. Many times without offering prayer I took the meal. Many times because of me one goat was killed and others were killed. Many times I didn't express my gratitude to your teacher and parents also. So there is a lot of dosh which we are born with. And if that is not cured, then it will afflict us in various ways. As a situational problem, as a body problem, as a children problem, as a mother problem, father problem, it will not be a simple matter. Official problem, sibling problem, mental problem is evergreen. Then this will happen, that will happen. Nothing is without a solid cause.